He opened the door. "What happened to you?" he asked, starting to laugh. Then he looked at Clear's face. "I fell into the river," she said. Her clothes and hair were wet. She was shaking with shock and cold.
"You don't want to go swimming in the Clyde in winter," said the truck driver. "It's too cold. Summer is better. Do you need a ride?"
Clear said yes and got into the truck. She knew she should tell the police immediately that somebody had tried to kill her. All she could think about, however, was getting home. She wanted a hot shower and dry clothes. The truck driver took her right to her front door. Clear thanked him.
"Will you be okay?" he asked.
"I think so," she replied. "I just need to get warm." She went inside. After showering, she put on some clean, warm pajamas and went into the living room. She was still shaking badly. She opened her bag and took out the paper with Marcus's number on it. It was wet, but she could just read the numbers. She dialed his home, but there was no answer. Then she tried his mobile, but all she got was his voicemail. She didn't leave a message. "Where is he?" she said out loud. Then she called the police and asked for D.I. Shannon Binlow. The detective asked her a few questions,